Hello everyone, this is Nagaraj Rebba. So today I am going to discuss balancing of the chemical equations in the chemical reactions. You know that in my last class I discussed the very important points which are present on the chemical equations, and today's class also I am going to discuss what are the important subtopics present on the chemical equations. So once I will review in my last class, so what I discussed with you in my last class, I will discuss with you first, and after that I am going to discuss what is the important subtopic present on the in our chemical equations. You know, in my last class I discussed with you, so what are the physical changes and what are the chemical changes. So generally you know that, so physical changes means it is nothing but a temporary changes. Physical changes means it is nothing but a temporary changes, and the chemical changes means it is called as a permanent changes. So generally, you know, in our surrounding, we are observing that so many reactions are going on. In that all reactions, which one is called as a physical and which one is called as a chemical, simply by the observation of their physical and by the observation of their properties. So by their properties, easily we will say the given one is called as a physical change or the given one is called as a chemical change, like that simply we will identify it. And at the same time, I discussed with you in my last class, so what are the important examples based on the physical change and chemical change. You know that burning of the crackers. So burning of the crackers is called as a permanent change. So permanent change means it is called as a chemical change. And burning of the wood and bomb blast and respiration process, whatever it. So by the observation of these all examples, they are all called as examples of the chemical changes. Chemical changes means it is nothing but a permanent change. And at the same time, by the observation of the physical changes. You know that physical changes means, suppose if you take a beaker and you will take the some amount of the water on the beaker, so by the continuously heating of that beaker, what will happen means, so the water molecules are evaporated and the water molecules are react with atmosphere. So by that reaction of atmosphere, so that is also called as a permanent change. If in case you will keep one plate on the beaker, so what will happen means, by the continuously heating of the beaker, what will happen, the water molecules are not evaporated. So the water molecules are collision with that wall, and again that vapor molecules are converting into a liquid molecules. So therefore that is called as a temporary change. So temporary change means it is called as a physical change, and permanent change means it is called as a a chemical change. So today's class, now I am going to discuss in our important subtopic which is present on the chemical equation. So that is called as a balancing of the chemical equations. See, so in this class I am going to discuss the balancing of the chemical equations. So this balancing of the chemical equation is very important. So definitely in the public examination they will ask the question, because of it is nothing but very important. So therefore in this class I am going to give the clarity, I am going to give the clear explanation based on these balancing of the chemical equations. So before I am going to discuss these balancing of the chemical equations, first I will discuss with you what is the chemical equation. What is the chemical equation? You know that chemical equation means it is nothing but a chemical substances are participating in the reaction. The chemical substances are participating in the reaction. So therefore the type of a reactions are called as a chemical equations. See here I am saying that, so these chemical equation, and at the same time you know that in our surrounding so many chemical reactions are going on. In that all chemical reactions are contains the two important parts. In our surrounding, by the observation of in our surrounding, so we are seeing so many chemical reactions. In the all chemical reactions, in the all chemical reactions, so there all contains the two important parts. One is called as the reactants. Two important parts. One is called as the reactants. One is called as the reactants, and the second one is called as the products. And the second one is called as the products. So first I am going to discuss the reactants, and after that I will explain the products. See here, I am saying the definition of the reactants. So definition of the reactants means the substances See here, this is called as a definition of the reactants. So this is called as a definition of the reactants. See, so the substances which are initially participating in the reaction, the substances which are initially participating in the reaction, so therefore they are all called as a reactants. The substances which are initially participating in the reaction, therefore they are all called as reactants. See here, I am saying one example. So based on these definition of the reactants, so carbon burns in the presence of oxygen atom, it will produce the carbon dioxide. So this is called as one of the chemical reaction. In this chemical reaction, these substances are called as initially participating substances. Carbon plus oxygen, we both are the initially participating substances in this chemical reaction. So therefore, these two one we are calling as a reactants. The substances which are initially participating in the chemical reaction, By the observation of these chemical equation, here, the carbon and oxygen both are acting as a, Why? Because initially these two are participating in the reaction. That's why simply we are saying these are all called as a reactants. And now I am saying that what is the definition of the products? So by the observation of definition of the product, here you will see. The substances which are found after completing of the reaction, Here you see same example I am saying here. So carbon burns. It will produce the carbon dioxide. See here, what I am saying that these two are called as a two substances which are initially participating in the reaction. So carbon and oxygen, they are all called as a two substances which are initially participating in the reaction. So that's why we are saying that the two are called as a reactants. So after completing of the reaction, so this one is called as a completing of the reaction, we are getting the carbon dioxide. Here the carbon dioxide is called as a product. So see here, so this arrow mark is indicating as a, so to completion of the reaction. See, so the head of the arrow mark, this one is called as a head of the arrow mark. So the head of the arrow mark is indicating as a to completion towards the product side. So therefore, always you must remember in your mind, so the head of the arrow mark indicating as a to complete the reaction means it is nothing but a towards the product side. So therefore, this is called as a reactants and products. I will say the two or three examples based on these reactants and products. After that, I am going to discuss the remaining points. See here. So suppose you are writing that. So CaO plus water molecule, it will use less to CaOH of taken twice. By the observation of this chemical equation, so these two are called as a two reactants. Why? Because these reactants are initially participating in the reaction. So these substances are initially participating in the reaction. So that's why we are saying these two are called as the reactants. So suppose if two or three reactants are present or two or three products are formed. So in that particular case, compulsory you must keep a positive sign. Compulsory you must keep a positive sign in between the two reactants. If in case what I am saying that, if in case so in our reaction contains two or more reactants or two or more products are formed. In that particular case, in between the two reactants or the two products are compulsory, you must keep, that is called as a positive sign. This positive sign is indicating as a addition of the two reactants or a combining of the two reactants, that is called as an indication of the positive sign. And you will see here, so what is the product means here, calcium hydroxide is called as a product. Calcium hydroxide is called as a product. Suppose you will see, I am writing that one more example, Zn plus H2SO4, it will give rise to ZnSO4 plus H2. By the observation of these reaction, in the left hand side two reactants are there and in the right hand side two products are there. Left hand side two reactants are there and right hand side two products are there. So compulsory you must keep these a positive sign in between the two reactants and in between the two products are compulsory you must keep the positive sign. And at the same time what I am saying that finally I will give the one conclusion. See here, so this is called as the arrow mark. These arrow mark left hand side, this one is called as the left. So this one is called as the left hand side and this one is called as the right hand side. Right hand side. So left side always you must write the reactants. Left hand side always you must write the reactants. Arrow mark. Arrow mark left hand side always you must write the reactants. And this one is called as an arrow mark. Right hand side always you must write the products. So this is called as one of the important symbolical representation of writing of a chemical equation. The symbolical representation of writing of a chemical equations, compulsory you must follow to these. So compulsory if in case two or three reactants are participated in the reaction, so you must keep in between the two or three reactants positive sign, that's very very important. And compulsory if in case that reaction will produce two or more products, in that particular case also you must write in between that products compulsory you must keep the positive sign. This is called as a one of the important of the writing of the chemical equation. And at the same time what I am saying that when you are writing any chemical equation, definitely that the chemical equation contains the two important parts, one is called as a reactant and the second one is called as a products. See, now I am going to discuss the balancing of the chemical equations. You know that in our surrounding we are writing the we are observing the so many chemical reactions. In that all chemical reactions are balanced or unbalanced, so compulsory you must identify. That's very important. So when we are discussing these balancing of the chemical equations, first you will observe the one important point, that is called as the law of conservation of a mass. Law of conservation of mass. So this is the very important principle, law of conservation of a mass. When you are balancing any chemical equation, compulsory you must follow. Yes, that equation compulsory follows the law of conservation of a mass. So what is the law of conservation of a mass means, sir? We are not to create any energy. We are not to create any energy and we are not to destroy any energy. We are not to create any energy and we are not to destroy any energy. But the amount of energy is distributed into the different forms. So therefore that is called as a law of conservation of a mass. See, once again I am saying that, so the important principle, that is called as the law of conservation of mass. You know that in our surrounding we are observing that so many, natural resources are there. Natural resources. Suppose a water molecule is called as one of the natural resources in our surroundings. And at the same time, petrol is also called as one of the natural resource. And the coal is also called as one of the natural resource. Like that, by the observation of these type of natural resources, so what I am saying that we are not to create any energy. We are not to create any energy and we are not to destroy any energy. Suppose water molecule. So the water molecule we are not created. And we are not destroying that water molecule also. But that water molecule we are using into the different forms. So in the different uses we are using, so therefore that is called as a law of conservation of a mass.
So once again I am saying that law of conservation of a mass means we are not to create any energy and we are not to destroy any energy. So therefore that one is called as the law of conservation of a mass. What I am saying that in our surrounding, by the observation of different types of chemical equations and physical equations, some equations are called as some equations means most of the equations are follows the law of conservation of a mass. And at the same time, what is the main important example of the law of conservation of a mass means so simply I am saying that water molecule and petrol and coal, like these type of examples are the examples of the law of conservation of a mass. We are not to create a water molecule and we are not to destroy the water molecule, but that water molecule we are using to the different processes, different works. So therefore that one is called as a law of conservation of a mass. When we are balancing any chemical equation, so definitely that chemical equation to follows the law of conservation of a mass. And at the same time, second point of these are balancing of the chemical equation. So if in case you will take any chemical equation, so compulsory that chemical equation compulsory contains the number of atoms present in the reactant side. The number of atoms present in the reactant side, that is a compulsory equals to the number of atoms present in the product side. So if in case you will write any chemical equation, that chemical equation, second point of the chemical equation, so compulsory the number of atoms which are present on the reactant side, that is a compulsory equals to the number of atoms which are present on the product side. Suppose you see, I am saying one example, C plus O2 is gives rise to CO2. Here you will see how many atoms are there in the reactant side. So this one is called as the reactant side and this one is called as the product side. Here how many atoms are there means here one carbon atom and two oxygen atoms. The total number of the atoms are 3. In the reactant side, the total number of atoms are 3. And what about the product side? Here one carbon atom is there, two oxygen atoms are there. The total number of atoms which are present on the product side also 3. So therefore, when we are writing the chemical equation, definitely the number of atoms which are present on the reactant side, that is the compulsory equals to the number of atoms which are present on the product side. That's a very very important point. And at the same time, the third point. So the third point of the balancing of the equation. So in the reactant side, how much amount of the weight is there? So what is the weight of the reactants? What is the weight of the reactants? That's a compulsory equals to the weight of the products. What is the weight of the reactants? That's a compulsory equals to the weight of the products. So that is also called as a very important. Suppose you see carbon atomic weight is 12. Carbon atomic weight is 12. And what about the oxygen? Here the two oxygen atoms are there. Every oxygen atom atomic weight is 16. Then you can see here 12 plus 32. So means this is called as 44 grams. So 44 grams is called as a weight of the reactants. The 44 grams is called as a weight of the reactants. And what about here? Carbon 12 plus 2 into 32. Same here. So here 12 plus 2 into 16. So therefore here the 32. In total here the products are also 44 grams. So by the observation of this one, what I have said, the third point. So what is the weight of the reactants? What is the weight of the reactants? That weight is a compulsory equals to the weight of the products. What is the weight of the reactants? That weight is a compulsory equals to the weight of the products by the observation of this equation. So here what I am saying that, so the carbon atomic weight is 12 and the oxygen atomic weight is 16, but here the two oxygen atoms are there, 2 into 16. So every oxygen atom atomic weight is 16, but here the two are there, 2 into 16. So 2 into 16 means it is called as 32. So therefore the total weight of the reactants is called as 44. The total weight of the reactants is called as 44. By the observation of the carbon dioxide also saying, here one carbon atom is there, two oxygen atoms are there. One carbon means this color is 12 grams and two oxygen atoms means 2 into 16. Then you are saying that here 32. So in total how much weight is there means 44 grams. So these three points are very very important when we are balancing the chemical equations. So compulsory we must focus on these three important points. So this is called as a balancing of the chemical equations. So see, I am saying some examples based on these balancing of the chemical equations. So in our textbook they given the first example. So water molecule, hydrogen react with oxygen, it will produce the water molecule. So this is called as a formation of a water molecule. So this is called as a formation of a water molecule. Hydrogen combined with oxygen. Hydrogen combined with oxygen, it will produce the water molecule. Hydrogen combines with oxygen, it will produce the water molecule. See here, in the left hand side, how many hydrogen atoms are there? In the left hand side, this is called as the left. In the left hand side, how many hydrogen atoms are there? Means hydrogen atoms are 2. In the left hand side, how many oxygen atoms are there? Means 2. So by the observation of the product side or right hand side, here in the right hand side also, how many hydrogen atoms are there? Means 2. The number of hydrogen atoms in the reactant side, product side or right hand side, that is present 2. And how many oxygen atoms are there? Means only 1. So therefore, here the left hand side, how many atoms are there? And the right hand side, how many atoms are there? Both are unequal. Both are not equal. So in that particular case, the given equation is called as an unbalanced equation or a skeletal equation. See here, in the left hand side, how many hydrogen atoms are there? Means 2. So in the right hand side, how many oxygen atoms are there? Means in the left hand side, how many oxygen atoms are there? Means 2. By the observation of the right hand side, how many hydrogen atoms are there? Means 2. So in the left hand side and right hand side, both the sides, the number of hydrogen atoms are balanced. But what about the oxygen atoms? Here in the left hand side, only 2 oxygen atoms are there. But in the case of the right hand side, only 1 oxygen atom is there. So therefore, the given equation is called as an unbalanced equation. So by the taking of this unbalanced equation, we must balance this equation. So how we will balance this equation is, which side is the deficient of that atom? So which side is the deficient of that particular atom? In that particular atom, you can add or you can multiply with a suitable integer value. So suppose you will see here, so here how many hydrogen atoms are there? Is 2. But here how many hydrogen atoms are there? Is 2. But here only 2 oxygen atoms are there, but here only 1. If in case you will multiply with here 2. So the coefficient of this water molecule is called as 2. Means we are multiplying with 2 with water molecules. So therefore, here the number of oxygen atoms are also 2 and the number of hydrogen atoms are 4. So here we will multiply with a suitable integer number, that is called as 2. Then 2 into 1 means 2 oxygen atoms are there, and in the reactant side also 2 oxygen atoms are there. So both sides the number of oxygen atoms are balanced. Now you can see in the reactant side how many hydrogen atoms are there, this is 2. But in the product side how many hydrogen atoms are there, this is 4. So therefore simply you can write here 2. So then both sides the number of hydrogen atoms are equal. So now you can write in the left hand side, means the reactant side, how many hydrogen atoms are there, this is 4. In the left hand side how many oxygen atoms are there, this is 2. By the observation of this one, in the left hand, right hand side how many hydrogen atoms are there, this is 4. In the right hand side, how many oxygen atoms are there? Means 2. So therefore, here the number of atoms which are present in reactant side, that is equal to the number of atoms which are present on the product side. So the number of atoms which are present in the reactant side, that is equal to the number of atoms which are present in the product side. And at the same time, so what is the weight of the reactants? That weight of the reactants are compulsory equals to the weight of the products. So therefore, this is called as a balancing of the equations. So which side is the deficient side? So deficient number of the atoms are there. In that deficient side, you can take the suitable integer. And you will multiply it. So then that is called as a balancing of that equation. So therefore this one is called as a balancing of these equation. And now I am going to discuss the one more balancing equation. See here I have written that. So simply, in our textbook they given that very important example, C3H8 plus O2, it will use rise to carbon dioxide plus water molecule. So here C3H8 means it is called as a propane. So propane is called as an organic substance. So this is C3H8 is called as a propane. This one is called as an organic substance. So this propane is a colorless and odorless liquid. The propane is called as the colorless and odorless gas. Where we are using these propane means by the heating purpose and cooking purpose we will use these propane. So these propane burns in the presence of oxygen atom. It will produce the carbon dioxide plus water molecule. So this one is called as an unbalanced equation. unbalanced equation. How we will identify the given one is called as unbalanced equation is, here three carbon atoms are there, but here only one carbon atom is there. Here three carbon atoms are there, but here only one carbon atom is there. So therefore, by the observation of the reaction, simply we are identified the given equation is called as a skeletal equation or unbalanced equation. Skeletal equation or unbalanced equation. So in this skeletal equation or unbalanced equation, by the multiplying of suitable integer value, by the multiplying of suitable integer value, then easily we will balance that equation. So see here, I'm writing that. So one by one step here. In the left hand side, how many carbon atoms are there? This is 3. But in the right hand side, how many carbon atoms are there? This is only 1. So therefore, I'm taking here C3H8+O2. It will give rise to here this carbon dioxide. I will multiply with 3. This is the carbon dioxide. I will multiply with 3. Why? Because here the 3 carbon atoms are there. That's why I will multiply with this carbon dioxide with 3. So then the 3CO2+H2O. So this is called as a balancing of the carbon in this equation. Balancing of the carbon. See here, how many carbon atoms are there? 3 into 1 means 3. And here how many carbon atoms are there? Means 3. So this is called as a balancing of the carbon. And now I am going to balance the next one is called as a hydrogen. Now I am going to balance the next one is called as a hydrogen. See here, how many hydrogen atoms are there? Means 8. But here how many hydrogen atoms are there? Means 2. So means here you will multiply with the suitable integer value. Then you can balance it. See here, I am writing that. So C3H8+O2, it will give rise to 3CO2+. Here I am multiplying with 4. So therefore, this one is called as 4H2O. Here the 2 hydrogen atoms are there. Before I will keep the 4. Then 4 into 2 means it is called as 8. 4 into 2 means it is called as 8. In the left hand side, you can see total 8 hydrogen atoms are there. And at the same time, right hand side also total 8 hydrogen atoms also there. So therefore, this is called as a balancing of the hydrogen atoms. Now, we will balance the oxygen. See here. Here 2 are there, but here 3 into 2, 6 plus 4 into 1, 10. See here, 3 into 2. So total 6 oxygen atoms are there. And here 4 into 1 means 4 oxygen atoms are there. So 6 plus 4 means total 10 oxygen atoms are there in the reactant side, product side. 10 oxygen atoms are there in the product side. But in the case of reactant side, how many are there? Means only 2. So then we can write C3H8+5O2. It will give rise to 3CO2+4H2O. See here. Here I am keeping the 5. So I am keeping the 5. Then 5 into 2 is 10. Now you can see here 3 into 2 is 10, 6 and 4 into 1 is 4. In total, how many oxygen atoms are there? It is 10 in the reactant side and 10 in the product side. So mostly we are writing this equation, most of the places, and sometimes we are writing this one is called as 2C3H8+10O2 is used as to 6CO2+8H2O. This is also called as a very important. So this equation, this total equation is multiplied with the 2, then 2C3H8+10O2 is gives rise to 6CO2+8H2O. So this is called as the simplest ratios, and this one is called as all are the, what is the integer values. So that is called as the even number values. But here you will see this one is called as an odd number, and this one is also called as an odd number, and this one is also called as an odd number. By the reducing of that odd numbers, simply we will multiply with the suitable integer that is called as the even number. So therefore, we will get that entire equation is called as in our even numbers. So therefore, we are writing, these two equations, both are correct. When we are writing that, so first equation is also correct and second equation is also correct. See here, once again I am saying it. So propane burns the price of oxygen atom, it will produce the carbon dioxide plus water molecule. So by the observation of that equation, here in the right hand, left hand side, 3 carbon atoms are there. In the right hand side, only 1 carbon atom is there. So therefore, we will identify the given equation is called as an unbalanced equation. So that unbalanced equation, by the following of law of conservation of a mass, by the following of number of atoms which are present in the reactant side, and the number of atoms which are present in the product side, based on that, and what is the weights of the reactants, that weights of the reactants is compulsory equals to the weights of the products. Based on these three principles, we will balance this equation. So first, which side is the deficient side? In that particular deficient side, you can multiply with the suitable integer value. So mostly, you will take the even numbers only. Mostly, you will balance with the even numbers. If in case you will take the odd numbers, we will get the more number of these steps. That's why mostly we are following with the, what is that, even numbers. So that's why here 3 carbon atoms are there. but here only one carbon atom is there. So before this carbon dioxide would write the coefficient 3, then here also 3 carbon atoms are there. Both sides, in the left hand side and right hand side, the number of the carbon atoms are balanced. If in case you write here, suitable coefficient value. Suitable coefficient value. What is the suitable coefficient means, here we are writing 3. 3 is called as the suitable coefficient. That's why here the number of carbon atoms also 3, and here also number of carbon atoms also 3. So then both sides the number of carbon atoms are balanced, and then we will go to balance the hydrogen. So here you will see, here in the left hand side how many hydrogen atoms are there, means 8, and what about in the right hand side, how many hydrogen atoms are there, means here only 2. So therefore, better to you keep a suitable integer value before the water molecule. So then this one is also called as a balance. So here I kept, so 4 is called as a suitable integer value. So then 4 2s are 8. 4 2s are 8 means 8 hydrogen atoms are there in the product side, and 8 hydrogen atoms are there in the reactant side. Then both sides are the number of hydrogen atoms are balanced. By the observation of next oxygen, here in the reactant side only 2 oxygen atoms are there, and in the product side 3 into 2, 3 into 2 means this color is 6, and here also 4 into 1 means 4, so 6 plus 4 means the total number of the oxygen atoms are 10, but here only 2 are there. If you multiply with the suitable integer value, then both sides are the oxygen atoms also balanced. So here I multiplied with the 5, so here 5 2s are 10, and the products are also 10 oxygen atoms are there. So therefore this one is called as the balancing of the equation. So what I told that here this equation contains odd numbers. By the reducing of that odd numbers, simply we will multiply with the suitable integer value, that is called as a suitable even number value. Then so the number of atoms which are present in the reactant side, it is a compulsory equals to the number of atoms which are present on the product side. So this is called as the balancing of the equations. So very important in our concept. And next I am going to discuss one more concept, a very important concept. Making chemical equations more informative. Making chemical equations more informative. This is a very important topic. Making chemical equations more informative. When we are making any chemical equation, when we will prepare any chemical equation, definitely we will follow the some important characteristic properties. When we will make the chemical equations, definitely we will follow the some important characteristic properties. So therefore that one is called as here I am writing that. So the first chemical property. So the first chemical, yes, what is the chemical characteristics of the chemical properties when we are making the chemical equation? The first one is called as the physical state. The first one is called as the physical state. And the second one is called as a heat changes. Second one is called as a heat changes. And the third one is called as a gas evolved. The third one is called as a gas evolved. The third one is called as a gas evolved. And the fourth one is called as a precipitate. Precipitate formed. See here, when we are making any chemical equation, so these are four important properties are very important. So these are all called as the very important characteristic properties by the preparing of any chemical equation. The first one is called as the physical state, and the second one is called as the heat changes, and the third one is called as the gas evolved, and the fourth one is called as the precipitate formed. Precipitate formed. Making a chemical equation is more informative. Making a chemical equation, by the preparing of any chemical equation, by the making of any chemical equation, definitely that chemical equation will contain these information, will contain these characteristic properties. So the characteristic properties, the first one is called as a physical state, and the second one is called as a heat changes, and the third one is called as a gas evolved, and the fourth one is called as a precipitate formed. See, one by one I will explain these characteristic properties when we are making the chemical equation. See here, the first one is called as a physical state. So physical state of the chemical equation. Suppose here I am writing that C plus O2, it will give rise to carbon dioxide. C plus O2, it will give rise to carbon dioxide.
When we are writing the physical states, generally in our chemistry we have the three important physical states are there. So if in case the given reactant or product, it is present in the solid state, so then simply we are writing that is called as a small s in the closed bracket. If in case the given one is called as a liquid, the given reactant or product is called as a liquid, simply we are writing the L in the closed bracket. If in case the given equation is present in the gas state, simply we are writing that G in the closed bracket. So what I am saying that, so the physical states, the reactants and products, simply present in the three important physical states. One is called as a solid, so second one is called as a liquid, so and the third one is called as a gases. Solids, liquids and gases. So what I am saying that, so what is the simplest form? The simplest form of the solids means, simply we are writing in the closed bracket. And what is the simplest form of the liquids means, L. And what is the simplest form of the gases means, G. Here you see the carbon is present in the solid form. So simply I am writing the physical state of the carbon is a solid. And what about the physical state of the oxygen means, it is called as a gas. And what about the physical state of the carbon dioxide means, it is also called as a gas. So this is called as a writing of the physical states of the reactants and products. Physical states of the reactants and the products. So compulsory what I am saying that when we are writing chemical equation, so definitely that chemical equation contains the two important parts, reactants and products. So generally these reactants and products are present in the three different physical states. One is called as the solids, and the second one is called as the liquids, and the third one is called as the gases. So solids means we are representing as a simply S, and liquids means we are representing as a L, and gases means we are representing as a G. So therefore this is called as a symbolic representation. And now I am writing the one more equation, N2 plus O2 equal U size to 2NO. Here you will see the nitrogen is called as a gas, and here the oxygen is also called as a gas. So then you will see here nitrogen oxide is also called as a gas. So this is called as an identification or a representation of physical states of the reactants and products. And the next I am going to discuss, the next one is called as a heat changes. In this heat changes, we have the two types of heat changes are there. One is called as an exothermic reaction. And the second one is called as an endothermic reaction. So we have the two types of heat changes are there. One is called as an exothermic reaction, and the second one is called as an endothermic reaction. So exothermic means it is called as a releasing of heat energy. Is called as an exothermic reaction, and absorption of heat energy. Is called as an endothermic reaction. See here, exothermic reaction means it is called as a releasing. And endothermic reaction means it is called as a absorption of heat energy. Suppose I will say one example, sun rays. So with respect to you, sun rises. So sunrises are, the sun release the heat energy. In that particular case, sun is acting as an exothermic reaction. Human beings and animals and plants. Absorb the heat energy. So with respect to human beings, plants and animals, they are all called as an endothermic reaction. So what I am saying that here, heat changes means we have the two types of a heat changes are there. One is called as exothermic reaction, and the second one is called as endothermic reaction. Exothermic reaction means it is called as a releasing of heat energy. Releasing of heat energy. Endothermic reaction means it is called as a absorption of heat energy. Suppose I will write one example. See, I will give the clarity based on these. I am writing a C plus O2. It will give rise to CO2. Here, sometimes we are writing the plus Q. And here you will see, I am writing that N2 plus O2, it will give rise to 2NO. Here I am writing the minus Q. See, this is called as a chemical equation, but here Q is called as a change in heat energy. The Q is indicating as a change in heat energy. Q is indicating as a change in the heat energy. But here we will mention the positive sign. So these are positive sign indicating as a exothermic reaction. The positive sign is indicating as a exothermic reaction. The positive sign is indicating as a plus Q. Plus Q means it is called as an exothermic reaction. Here you will see minus Q. These are minus Q is indicating as a endothermic reaction. The minus Q is indicating as a endothermic reaction. So plus Q is indicating as exothermic reaction and minus Q is indicating as a endothermic reaction. So this is called as a identification of the given equation is called as an endothermic reaction or exothermic reaction. So next one, gas amount. Next one is called as a gas amount. So gas amount means, suppose you will see, I am writing the one equation. Zinc react with the sulfuric acid, H2SO4. It will give rise to ZnSO4. ZnSO4 plus, here the H2 gas is released. See here, so this is one of the chemical equation here. Zinc is react with the sulfuric acid. It will produce the ZnSO4 plus hydrogen gas is liberated. ZnSO4 plus hydrogen gas is liberated. Here the important representation, the evaluation of a gas. So here you will see, these are upward arrow mark. These upward arrow mark is indicating as a, yes, a releasing of a gas. So therefore this is called as a identification of a gas. And next I am going to discuss, next one is called as a precipitate formed. So precipitate formed means, see here, I am saying one example based on these precipitate formed. AgNO3, silver nitrate, react with the NaCl. Then it is forming as a AgCl plus NaNO3. So silver nitrate react with the sodium chloride. It will produce the silver chloride and the sodium nitrate. In this equation, so simply the precipitate formed means it is called as a downward arrow mark. Here you will see, we are writing here the downward arrow mark. Here the AgCl is acting as a precipitate. Always you must remember the downward arrow mark is indicating as a precipitate formula. So these are four important characteristic properties are very important when we are making the chemical equations. Once again I am saying that physical state, and the second one is called as a heat changes, and the third one is called as a gas evolved, and the fourth one is called as a precipitate formula. So physical states means generally reactants and products are present in the three important physical states: solids, liquids and gases. So solids means a simple form we are writing S, and liquids means a simple form we are writing as a L, and gases means simply we are writing as a G. Sometimes we are writing that aqueous. So aqueous means it is nothing but a AQ. Aqueous means it is nothing but a the particular substance which is dissolved on the water molecule. Like the type of solutions we are calling as a aqueous solutions. Aqueous means it is nothing but a symbolical representation of aqueous solution is a AQ. So therefore this is a third very important physical state. And next one is called as a heat changes. We have the two types of heat changes are there. One is called as exothermic reactions and second one is called as endothermic reactions. So third one is called as a gas evolved. Upward arrow mark is indicating as a gas evolved, and the downward arrow mark indicating as a
yes, a precipitate formed. So this is for us a very important subtopic which is present on the chemical equations, and the remaining subtopic I will explain in my next class. Thank you very much.